Dr. Hotez, clearly the logistics of vaccinating the world, because I think one of the lessons, and this is something Lori Garrett and I talked about in the last hour, is that if the whole world isn't safe, then none of us are safe. But talk about both aspects of Keir's reporting, the significance of vaccinations commencing today in the UK and the long, long road ahead.
Yeah, a few things, Nicolle. You know, everyone is talking about what a miracle the vaccines are, and they are a miracle in one sense. But, you know, sometimes people think that these vaccines just popped out of nowhere over a period of 4 months. And one of the things that I've been trying to explain to people, if they think vaccines are rushed, this is not a 4-month process. This is a 17-year process. The discovery and development of vaccines for coronaviruses began 17 years ago after SARS emerged in 2003. That was the first big pandemic coronavirus that started out of South China and shut down Toronto, Canada for a while. That's when we identified the spike protein as the soft underbelly of the virus. That's when experimental vaccines first developed, so that when the Chinese put up the sequence of COVID-19 on bioarchive in January, the coronavirus community, the community of coronavirus vaccine researchers looked at this and said, oh, we got this. We know how to make a COVID-19 vaccine. And then it was a matter of which technology could go the first, could be the fastest, and which technology would be the most enduring. And so all of the vaccines that you're hearing about, whether it's AstraZeneca or Pfizer or Moderna or J&J or ours, which is being scaled in India, all target that spike protein. And that's important that people realize that this was not rushed. This was a deliberate long-term program. So it's really exciting to see this vaccine go into Maggie's arm. And I'm so thrilled for her and her family. Yeah. And this will be scaled up in England. And now we'll be moving to the U.S., I think, in a few days.
I think what you said sounds like it's very important in the category of reassuring people of the safety, especially on a day when Republicans in the Senate Homeland Security Committee had a vaccine skeptic testify, something that I think alarms a lot of folks. I want to give you a minute to just put what you just said in even more context. And let me just ask it this way. So you're saying that the kind of virus that carried COVID all over the world in the last 10 months is from a sort of family of viruses that scientists like yourself have been studying for a long time. And once they got the specifics, they were able to sort of fine tune, put the finishing touches on this vaccine. Is that basically what you're explaining?
That's right. So, you know, after we saw SARS in 2003, then there was Middle Eastern respiratory in 2012. We said, well, hang on, there's a new coronavirus coming every decade. We knew there was another one coming. And again, this is the power of the National Institutes of Health and National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, headed by Tony Fauci, Francis Collins heading NIH. They launched a major program for coronaviruses starting in 2003. We were the beneficiaries of that. We got funded to develop some of the first prototype vaccines. So this all was very deliberate by the U.S. government and the NIH to really move this forward. Again, this is why, you know, we're very blessed to have the NIH here in the United States and funding that research. And we still have a long ways to go, because we're going to have to see how this vaccine rolls out in terms of being able to scale it up, how robust the production process will be. This is a brand new technology, and that's the reason why we're bringing on other vaccines on top of it, the adenovirus vaccines. We're going to need at least 4 or 5 different vaccines to vaccinate the U.S. population. We will not do this with just the 2 mRNA vaccines.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.